Wagner's classification is a widely utilized system for categorizing the severity of diabetic foot ulcers, helping healthcare professionals to better understand the condition and formulate appropriate treatment plans. Grade 0. This stage indicates the absence of open wounds or ulcers. Patients may exhibit signs of neuropathy, vascular disease, or both. Intervention strategies include regular foot examinations to identify deformities or high-pressure areas. Patient education on proper foot care, including regular cleaning and moisturizing. Grade 1. Superficial ulcers involve the epidermis and possibly the dermis. The ulcer may be characterized by callus formation and inflammation. Intervention strategies include glycemic control and antibiotic to control infection, and offloading pressure from the affected area using appropriate footwear or orthotic devices. Grade 2. At this stage, the ulcer extends deeper, involving ligaments, tendons, or joint capsules. Infection and cellulitis may be present. Intervention strategies include aggressive wound care to prevent infection, regular monitoring for signs of worsening ulcers, and offloading pressure with specialized footwear. Grade 3. Deep ulcers penetrate into deeper structures, such as bone or joint. The risk of severe infection, including osteomyelitis, is significantly increased. Intervention strategies include intensive antibiotic therapy to control infection. Surgical intervention may be necessary to drain abscesses or debride necrotic tissue, and close collaboration with a multidisciplinary healthcare team. Grade 4. Gangrene, characterized by tissue death, typically involves the forefoot. Partial or complete auto-amputation of the toes may occur. Intervention strategies include urgent surgical intervention to remove necrotic tissue, strict glucose control to promote healing, and continued monitoring for signs of systemic complications. Grade 5. The most severe stage, this grade signifies widespread gangrene affecting the entire foot. Urgent intervention, such as amputation, may be necessary to prevent systemic complications. Collaboration with rehabilitation services to optimize patient outcomes post-amputation is essential. Remember, effective management involves a collaborative, multidisciplinary approach that encompasses glycemic control, wound care, infection control, and, when necessary, surgical procedures. If you found this video informative, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more health content.